this race. This is great, great racing here, and moving now up there with them is the Canadian Porter, and he also a past world champion.
Here's our first view now. We're in the men's single sculls final. Give you a lane order. Estonia 1, Germany 2, Switzerland 3, New Zealand 4, Canada in 5, and Bulgaria at lane at number 6. And the Olympic champion is just phenomenally fast. And we're still waiting, though, for the result of the final of the women's single scull. That has not been confirmed yet. We're waiting a long time for the photo finish on that. And meanwhile, though, this heavyweight final, the men's single scull, is powering down the course. Fabulous conditions. We've got flat water, we've got no wind, and we've got the Olympic champion now pushing on fast. He's had a phenomenal second 500, and now the world champion, there's the Olympic champion, Zeno Müller. He grimaces, but watch the blade work and down the legs. He's just pushing it hard.
He's a very, very compact sculler. He's very, very explosive. He actually won the first World Cup round against Waddell some 3 months ago. And then he didn't turn up for the final of the World Cup in Lucerne. He thought, I've done the business. I'm going home. I'm going to wait for the Olympics.
At the halfway mark, though, but it's feet and inches between the Olympic champion and the world champion. Those two out front now. There's about 2.15 seconds for Canada in third place. Canada, let's not discount Derek Porter. He's an Olympic champion back in 92 in the men's eight. He's world champion in this event in 1993, and he's coming back to form now, so we are really in for a cracking race. And the final, the men's single sculls. Men's single sculls, psychologically the hardest event. It's the real determination. It's just down to you, isn't it, obviously?
It's real cat and mouse stuff. And look at this. Rob Waddell has not been in this position. He usually goes right out in front, and everybody has to chase him, and he can watch the field. Here, he's under pressure now from Zeno Müller. Now we're going to see what Rob Waddell has got, because the strength and the power of this sculler could be rattled by Zeno Müller leading him. How is he going to respond? Because these long arms, he's usually such a smooth sculler, very, very strong. Can he match Zeno Müller? And has Zeno Müller changed his race plan, gone out early, and is this going to be a real problem for Zeno Müller? Is he going to have his last sprint?
So these two scullers now have left the pack. So Derek Porter has not been able to live for the time being with this blistering pace. Rob Waddell, 36 and a half strokes per minute. He's taking 36 strokes of these ones in a minute, which is a blistering pace in this event. 38, though, up top there, the Olympic champion. The Olympic champion leads by a quarter of a canvas. And we look back in this clear water. And these boys here now are chasing bronze, because it'll take a phenomenal effort for this chasing the pack here to get back up. And there's Derek Porter. Well, we had big hopes for him for a gold medal today, to be challenging in there, but he hasn't lived with his blistering pace.
Well, in Lucerne, in the World Cup Lucerne, he was second, very close second to Waddell. So this is a measure of how these two are going in front.
And we're into now the last quarter. There are 500 metres remaining in the final of the men's single scull, and it has lived up to expectation. We have the Olympic champion. There he is in the white boat. We have the world champion in the black boat. It's Switzerland, New Zealand. And there's the picture of the Olympic champion. But Rob Waddell, there he goes now. We have 400 metres. He is V12. He has the power just to push on. And hasn't he timed it? Now out to a canvas, up to half a length. Up to half. He's pushing. He's going, and I don't think this Olympic champion is responding, Dan.
He can't. He did all his work in the first part. He thought he was going to take him by surprise. He thought that he was going to give him a totally different sort of race plan, and it's Waddell who's got the surprise. It's Waddell who is pushed on now. I'm an Olympic champion who is so used to these last 500-meter sprints, he's got nothing in response. It's Waddell who's taking it on.
250 meters remain in this final of the men's single scull, and Rob Waddell, the world champion, 36 strokes per minute, and he just continues to walk away. Psychologically, he has broken the Olympic champion Zeno Müller from Switzerland. That's what it's all about in there, because all these scullers are technically good scullers. Zeno Müller down to 34. Remember, he was at 38 strokes per minute, about 250 meters back. And Zeno Müller now is just going to have to hang on for that silver medal. But here comes Derek Porter. Remember, I mentioned him. He's pushing on. He will see out of the corner of his eye that the Olympic champion has blown. He has given it all. Out front, though, the gold medal is going to the world champion, the reigning world champion from New Zealand. We have 50 meters up to the line. Rob Waddell, V12. It's a comfortable win for him. And it really is a worthy win, but it's a chase now for silver and bronze. And Juri Jaanson almost on the line for bronze. He's got his arms in the air, but I don't think so. Out front there, we've got New Zealand